status competition keeps us racing to publish, and if we fail in that regard, punishment is swift and severe. Teaching. Dr. Blip Quarterly taught full-time, though his employment was considered part-time. I, on the other hand, have not taught a class in over 5 years. I, Dr. Flake Fountain, molecular geneticist, have been a willing and well-paid servant. A slave butler who gets to wear fancy clothes and sleep in the mansion, but a slave nonetheless, and subject to beatings if I don't cower with a bow. My department attracts millions of dollars to the university, and only the football program generates more revenue. Many of my colleagues believe, with the peculiar pride of a master's pet slave, that we will overtake the TU turkeys within a few years. They are probably correct. Only 4 years ago, we seceded from the biology department and formed the Department of Molecular Genetics. There had been considerable hostility between the ecologists, drawn to biology via the essays of Emerson, Thoreau, and Muir, and the molecular geneticists, drawn to biology via the promise of research stipends the size of sequoias. Our new department, though in its infancy, is already well larded by a smeary smattering of government agencies, private foundations, and corporate sponsors. Piggish and raised on the blubber of bureaucracy, we show no signs of shedding our baby fat. My specialization is recombinant genetics. I have found my tasks challenging, and have gotten a thrill from attracting grant money to the department. Just last year, I received the largest grant yet. The windfall came from a venture capitalist who was financing the formation of a startup biotechnology corporation. He wanted me to break the 13-mile-per-hour barrier in tomato harvesting.